Presenting PC's 12 rules of becoming the best version of yourself. So here are a few of my favorites from my list. There's only one you, okay? Because there's no one like you. And I don't mean the superfluous, superficial parts. I'm talking about the core of you, who you are inside, your values, your beliefs, your flaws. And once you understand who really that person is, you would have taken the first step in finding your unique self, and that is the best version of you. Who am I really? Most often, we don't allow ourselves the ability to dream beyond our imagination. We don't allow ourselves to think about the future because we are afraid of change. We are afraid to move away from what is familiar. Either that or sometimes, you know, we are too rigid to let our dreams evolve. Change is the only constant thing in life, and you are never too old or never too experienced to learn something new. Believe that you have everything already as your Brahmastra in your will to be able to be and achieve your dreams. Be fearless. I know I wanted to become an aeronautical engineer. What am I today? I'm an actor, I'm a singer, I'm an author, I'm a producer, I'm an artist. How did I go from becoming an engineer to all of these things? I made choices. The choices that I wanted for myself. That is my rule number two. Let your dreams fly. Give them wings. Be who you want to be just by being fearless. Now, opportunities. That's another important part of being fearless. They're a very funny thing, huh? These opportunities. They don't come very often. They come far and few in between. But when they do we recognize them? Our job is to recognize them and make the most of them. I look back on all the things that I've done and I marvel at the opportunities that came my way. Miss India, Miss World, when I was in Bareilly in Army School, my first film offer, my first music single, the first film I actually produced. There was never a plan, ever. More like the universe sort of guiding me towards these opportunities. All I had to do was recognize them and make sure I worked so hard that I squeezed every drop out of these opportunities. This, ladies and gentlemen, is called drive. It's called ambition. So no matter where you are in life, rule number three is you have never arrived enough to explore new opportunities. And there's nothing wrong with being ambitious. Ladies, listen to me. Now, for all of you guys who like everything in life, I don't think there's anything wrong with wanting to have the whole cake and eat it too. Nothing wrong. I want everything. Mujhe sab kuch chahiye. And there's nothing wrong with that. As long as you're not harming someone or doing something wrong, don't be scared to want more for yourself than you ever thought you could. I'll give you a small example. A few years ago, I was shooting a film called Dawn 2. You've heard of that, right? So it was chosen to be shown at the Berlin Film Festival, Berlinale, and my entire team was flying for the premiere, and it was a very exciting time. But at the same time, I was invited for the first time to attend the Grammy Awards in LA. So now, and I was doing music, it was this big choice. Both the events were literally taking place one day apart in completely different time zones, Berlin and LA. My team and everyone around me told me, no, it can never happen. You have to choose what is your priority. And you know what I did? I made some insane connections. Mumbai to London, London to Berlin, Berlin to Amsterdam, Amsterdam to LA, LA to Mumbai in 3 days. And I made it happen. I went to both events and I looked great at both events. Even though I hadn't slept, it took a little bit of extra makeup, but I was fine. And that's not the only time I've done it. I've done it so many times, over and over again. Why? Because I don't want anyone to tell me I can't have everything. I want to dream of everything and I'll have everything. So rule number four, be greedy. Be greedy for your ambitions. Be hungry for it. Don't live on someone else's benchmarks. We are told so many times in our life, nahi, लड़की को तो ये करना चाहिए या तुम लड़के हो सबसे बड़े. Your responsibility is this. This is who you should be. Who can tell you who you should be? Don't let anyone or any situation dictate to you who you are and who you can be. I know it's very much easier said than done. I know that because I've done it. But fight for your dreams. Because no one else is going to fight for your dreams except you. I've turned down so many roles, opportunities, because they did not fit into what I thought at that time was the right thing for me. So today, my path is just my own. It belongs to no one. My failures, my successes, all of it, mine, my journey, all of it is mine. So rule number 5, do not compromise. Do not settle on your dreams. Now, who likes to fail? What? What? At least 15 logon ne haath uthaya. I'm really confused with this audience right now. Did you like to fail? Well, I'm not talking to you guys. I'm talking to those guys who hate to fail. Because I hate to fail. It's really as simple as that. It takes tubs and tubs of ice cream, lots of tissues, lots of tears, lots of dramebazi, my mother, my best friends, my family, everybody making me feel better about it. But the one thing that is as certain as night and day, ladies and gentlemen, is that you will fail. It's just how it is. And there is nothing that you can do to stop that. It's what you do after that'll define where you go. When something I've invested in my heart and my soul, which I do with everything that I actually put my mind to, if that fails, I don't just wallow in self-pity. I roll myself in it. I roll around in it. I wrap myself in it, head to toe, self-pity, self-pity, self-pity. It's not a pretty sight. I can tell you that. My mother, who's sitting right here, has witnessed it many times. But then, I get up, cry a little, dust myself off and dive straight back into life, because the only way to push failure aside is to move ahead, not ignore it, analyze it, and learn from it. Always remember, you will never truly enjoy success until you have tasted failure. And trust me when I tell you, it tastes like shit. It really does. So rule number 6, fail, fail, fail again, and then rise like a phoenix. Now, what is life without a little bit of a risk, right? No, I'm not an adrenaline junkie. I'm not telling you to go off roller coasters or anything. I've always believed that you have to take risks, calculated, educated risks, to evolve. Because if you've not truly explored the full extent of your possibilities, you'll always remain stagnant. People have written me off several times in my career. Sometimes they didn't agree with my choices. When I played a negative character in my film Aitraaz, very early in my career, I was told I'll be a vamp and no one will cast me as a heroine. When I